Sometimes people comment on my channel and say that I'm angry. I deny this because I know, or at least I think I know, that they're insinuating that I'm angry at Yahweh or I'm angry at church people, neither of which is true. Yahweh doesn't exist. Anyway, I'm 99.99999% sure that Yahweh doesn't exist and never did. I'm as positive of that as I can be. And would say I'm 100% sure, but I don't know how I could be completely sure. I mean, anything's possible. Jesus might have existed once upon a time. I mean, as a man, not as God. And you know what? Maybe Yahweh existed as a human being. Maybe he was a king or a lord, the warrior son of a higher lord or king named El Elyon. And you know how stories about people become inflated and outrageous. People write stories. The Hebrews wrote them, the Sumerians wrote them, the Egyptians wrote them, the Greeks wrote them, and we write them today. So just as I'm not angry at Zeus or Mithras or Apollo or Rumpelstiltskin or Darth Vader or Dr. Robotnik, I'm not angry at Yahweh or Jesus. And church people have done nothing to me. Well, sure, I've spent a lot of time around church people, and we all occasionally hurt one another if we spend enough time together. So people have hurt me, and I've hurt people. But anger at Yahweh or humans had absolutely nothing to do with my leaving Christianity. To me, that would make absolutely no sense at all. I mean, seriously, think about it. I believe in Christianity and think I need to be a Christian to save my soul. But I don't like the God of Christianity or the people don't live up to biblical standards. And so I get angry and just discard my salvation and decide I want to go to hell. I mean, am I a complete idiot? No, I'm not. Therefore, I didn't give up my faith because I'm angry. However, the other night I was lying in bed and realized I was indeed angry. Just not at any God or any person. We can be angry without being angry at someone else. Sometimes we're just angry at the situation we're in. For instance, somebody we love dies and we're angry. So yes, maybe I am angry, but if so, what am I angry about? Well, I'll tell you. I'm angry that I was beguiled. Not by any humans of today. They were beguiled just the same way I was. And those who wrote the documents contained in the Bible, they might have been beguiled, or might have been writing literature that they never expected us to take seriously or literally. I'm also angry that I wasn't capable of not being beguiled. I'm angry that I wasted most of my life on a book of myths, legends, and fairy tales. A book that not only didn't help me, but actually hurt me and continues to hurt people I love. I'm angry that I grew up scared. I couldn't even enjoy the sound of a train. Every time I heard one whistle, I feared it might be Gabriel blowing his trumpet. And naturally, most of us do, I felt unworthy to be in the presence of a holy God. I'm angry that I trusted men simply because they were Christians. I'm angry that I allowed those men to influence me and have power over me. I'm angry that I couldn't speak out strongly enough because women should be quiet. And angry that I allowed men to say and do horrible things to me because I didn't know how to stand up for myself. I'm angry that I couldn't pursue dancing or singing or acting. Not that I would have made it big or anything, but I would have greatly enjoyed participating more in these activities. I mean, even angry that as a writer, I had to make sure everything I wrote glorified Yahweh, which greatly stunted my creativity. And I'm not saying I wanted to write porn. There's a big gap between writing porn and making sure what I wrote expressed some kind of glory for Yahweh. I'm angry that I looked down on perfectly fine people because they weren't Christians or weren't part of my denomination. I'm angry that because I thought Yahweh would be angry with me if I didn't, I said things to people that I regret. I'm angry that I brought my children up wasting their lives. We missed out on some time with extended family and my kid's dad because we had to be in church. I'm angry because as long as I live, I I know I won't fully shake off the shackles of Christianity. It will always affect me, one way or another. You know what I think I'm angriest about? There are people who love me and people who love you who will tell us every time they see us that they love us, yet they worship and praise the monster they believe will eventually burn us. No, hell is not real, but that's beside the point. They think it is, and they think we're going there. And they plan to worship the monster they think will be burning us, whom they claim to love. And some of them can't wait for the fire to be ignited. And that's pitiful. These people are so scared out of their gourd that they will strike the match themselves if Jesus tells them to, and throw alcohol on us for good measure. They'll even do that to the person they love most in the world. Well, at least they think they should. Whether they would is another question. I'm angry that I know this. I'm angry that I used to be one of these people. And I'm angry that I now have to know how utterly heinous that is. I was a monster. And yeah, I'm super angry about that. Anyway, yeah, I'm angry. Maybe I always will be. I don't think about it much, and I only just realized it the other day. But again, I'm not angry at anybody, not even Christians who probably would throw hot oil on me today if Jesus told them to. They're deluded and they're frightened. Oh, they'll pretend it's all about love, but you and I know better. They're scared. And they obey to get good things and avoid evil for themselves. I feel sorry for these people. I mean, I get it. If someone aims a gun at us and we can shoot first, we probably will. And if Christians don't participate in Yahweh's vengeance on us, if he commands it, they'll get thrown into who? He's horrible, and they know it. If the fire were real anyway, and again, they think it is. I spent about 50 years of my life getting this. We're weak. We're afraid. Shoot, we're terrified and petrified. We have a very powerful desire to stay alive and not to be in pain. And we all do bad things for less dangerous reasons than burning in hell. But yes, it angers me that we as human beings are subjected to this crap. I'm angry that people I love can't love me back the way they should because of fear and a horrible belief system. But I'm a pretty optimistic person, so I don't think about this stuff much. From time to time, though, anger does arrive. I feel it and I move on. And as I said, I only recently realized that it is indeed anger. So I think those people who call me angry did me a favor. I think they helped me recognize anger in myself. It's just not stemming from what they no doubt think it is. I'm grateful that I myself no longer have to be willing to harm others or rejoice when they're harmed just to save myself. That is a horrible belief system. It should have never been foisted upon us. Thank you all. Bye.